In yet another shocking case of crime against women, civic workers of BBMP, the civic body of Bengaluru, were assaulted and even threatened with rape by a contractor. All of this only because these women raised their voice to ask for their pending dues. Now, it's been 7 days since a case has been registered against the contractor, but he's on the run. There is no clue yet with the police about his whereabouts. A manhunt has been launched. Shrija gets us more details.
It's been more than 6 days since a case was registered here at KR Puram police station against a contractor identified as Nagesh after he was accused of assaulting the Paurakarmikas, the conservancy workers who keep the city clean. In fact, we are given to understand the incident took place on October 13th, where these Paurakarmikas, who have not been paid the salaries for over 2 months, went and asked their contractor to pay the salaries. But after he did not have an answer to them, in fact, he flashed his private pass and also threatened to rape them, is what these conservancy workers are claiming. Soon after, they registered a complaint with the KR Puram police station, enraged by this complaint. In fact, Nagesh, along with some of his men henchmen, brought these men armed with, rods and tried to beat these Paurakarmikas, is what we are given to understand at this point in time. As far as this case goes, we understand that Nagesh has been booked under IPC Section 354 for outraging modesty of a woman and also for Atrocities Act. But however, the contractor Nagesh is at this point in time absconding. However, his henchman at this point in time has already been arrested by the police. But what we want to know is, as far as the Paurakarmikas are concerned, how long before will they continue to suffer until the government, in fact, comes up with solid and strategic rules that they will be paid continuously through, in fact, contract system. With camera person Pradeep, this is Shrija reporting for Mirror Now in Bengaluru.
Activist Kartiyani on the phone line with me. Thank you for speaking to us here on Mirror Now. Now, what is the solution? This is not the first time these people have fought back for their pending dues, for their own wages, and have suffered the brunt of that.
Hello?
Yes, go ahead, please. Can you hear me?
Yes. You know, this is a continuing struggle of the Paurakarmikas. First of all, they are handicapped because they belong to the lower castes and they are women. So they are doubly disempowered, and the contractors have been exploiting them for more than 20 years now. Now, the government has decided to do away with the contract system, and I think that is the reason why the contractors are up in arms against the Paurakarmikas, because they used to exploit them mercilessly for 20 years. Mm. And now that the Paurakarmikas have been empowered by removing the contract system, the contractors, you know, are no longer able to stomach that their huge profits that they were making by giving bogus names of Paurakarmikas and drawing salaries in their names, it has come to an end. And that is what is making them all angry against the Paurakarmikas. And they're taking it out on the Paurakarmikas because they can't take it out on the government or the state.
So what's the solution then? Should the government not be providing them additional security? This contractor specific to this case who thrashed them and got them beaten up by his goons allegedly is on the run. And they have not found him for the past 1 week.
It just shows, you know, that the nexus of the councillors, the contractors and the bureaucrats has been so strong that they were like a mafia, and the government is finding it difficult to break this nexus and the mafia involved. So they have to take strong steps now to really put in place a proper system and give protection to the Paurakarmikas. And also, you know, the government has never been giving representation to the Paurakarmika union in making any decisions. So they need to be brought on to the decision-making bodies so that their voice is heard and that their woes are listened to. Now, they've also brought ESMA on the Paurakarmikas. I agree that the solid waste management is a, essential service. But they should not stop the grievance redressal mechanism for the Paurakarmikas to air their grievances and get redress also. It's very important. There is something called a solid waste management expert committee. Mm. And these Paurakarmikas, the workers are not represented on that committee. So they are not asked anything when decisions are taken about them. So I think they need to be given representation on this decision-making body, and only then, you know, some empowerment of their of the women will happen.
Yes, absolutely. They need to be given a platform for sure. They need to be empowered a little bit more so the people don't exploit them the way it's been done for all of these years. Thank you so much for speaking with us. Let's listen into some of these workers and what they had to tell us about the kind of atrocities that were carried out.
ನಾವು ಹೋಗಿ ಸರ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಈ ತರ ಮೂರು ತಿಂಗಳಿಂದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಕೊಡಿ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಹೋಗಿ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಿ. ಆರ್ ಎಸ್ ಎರಡು ವರ್ಷದ್ದು ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗಿ ಸ್ಯಾಲ್ರಿ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಗಲೀಜ್ ಮಾತೆಲ್ಲ ಮಾತಾಡಿ ರಾರ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬಂದ ಮೇಡಮ್ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಹೊಡಿಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ. ಅವಾಗೆ ನಾವು ತಕ್ಷಣ ಹೋಗಿ ಬಿ ಪಿ ಎಂ ಪಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟರ್ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಕಳಿಸಿ ನಾವು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ರಿ.
ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು 12,000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಅಂದ. ನೀನೇನು ಹಂಗೆ ಹಿಂಗೆ ಅಂತ ಮಾತಾಡಿದ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ರಾರ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಮತ್ತೆ 12,000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಬೇಕೋ ಅವರೆಲ್ಲ ಗಿಡದ ಪಕ್ಕ ನಡೀರಿ, ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ರಿಗಿನ್ನೂ 12,000 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿನೇ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ, ಬಟ್ಟೆಯೆಲ್ಲ ಬಿಚ್ಚಿಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೊಡಿತೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಯಾರೋ ಹುಡುಗನ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ಏ ಇವ್ರನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಹುಡುಗರನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಒಬ್ಬರನ್ನ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಗಿಡದ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಗಿಡ ಇದೆ ಮೇಡಮ್, ನಾವು ಅನ್ಲೋಡ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಗೋ ಹತ್ರ ಡೀಸೆಲ್ ಸಟ್ ರೋಡ್ ಅಂತ. ಏ ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಗಿಡಗಳಿದೆ, ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಡೀರಿ ಒಬ್ಬೊಬ್ರು, ರೇಪ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಬಿಸಾಕ್ಬಿಡೋಣ, ರೋಡಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ತಲೆ ಬಗ್ಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು.
ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಫೈಲ್ಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್ ಹರಾಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಬಿ ಬಿ ಎಂ ಪಿ ವಿತ್ ದ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ವೆಲ್ಫೇರ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ದ ಸೋಷಿಯಲ್ ವೆಲ್ಫೇರ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ದ ಪೊಲೀಸ್ ಟು ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಎನ್ ಎಫ್ ಐ ಆರ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ದಿ ಅಕ್ಯೂಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ದ ಎಫ್ ಐ ಆರ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ಡ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯು ನೋ ದ ಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್ ಹರಾಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಶುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಟು ದ ವುಮನ್ ವರ್ಕರ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೇಂಟ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದ ಸೆಕ್ಷುಯಲ್ ಹರಾಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಬಟ್ ನೋ ಸಚ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಷನ್ ವಾಸ್ ಗಿವನ್, ನೋ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ಸ್ ವರ್ ಟೇಕನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೆನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದ ಯು ನೋ ದ the accused realized that, you know, the complaint has been filed against him, and he again came on Thursday and has accused the he has harassed the woman on the street, in a public street. He has removed his trousers and he said all kinds of vile things. They've beaten the woman with a rod, they've got 4 to 5 local goons to threaten them and chase them to the police station, and in spite of all of this, the police even then did not file a complaint. They still delayed filing an FIR.